What's up, guys, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's look, we are going to be doing this very soft glam copper look. Don't forget to subscribe down below and give this video a big thumbs up, and let's get to it. So I am starting off today using the Master Palette by Mario, and I'm taking a fluffy blending brush, and I'm just blending this all over my crease and close to my brow bone. This is Isabelle from the Master Palette by Mario. It's just a very super warm orangey brown tone. Next, I'm going in with a more tapered blending brush, and I'm taking Violetta and blending that closer to my crease and the outer corner of my eye. It's okay if this gets a little bit messy because we're going to cut out the shape of our lid with concealer, so it's okay if it gets on the lid. And this look is meant to be extremely blended out and smooth and flawless, so take your time when you are blending. Another recommendation I have for this look is to build up the depth of the color versus starting with it extremely harsh. It's so much easier when you build up the darkness. And then I'm just going in with the fluffy blending brush and kind of blending those two colors together, so it's kind of a mix of going back and forth, building the depth and blending it out so that it's flawless. Next, I'm going in with the NYX eye primer. This is a tan base. I know in the lighting on my camera it doesn't look super tan, but in person it is. And the reason I'm doing this is because I'm going to be setting it with a warm copper shade, and so I felt like this gave it a really good base and it helped the copper pop even more. Next, I'm going in with a gorgeous golden copper shade called Ginger Snap from the Too Faced Grand Hotel Cafe palette trio. You don't have to use this exact one. Any sparkly copper shade will do, but I'm basically just patting this on with an angled brush, and the reason I'm using an angled brush is because I find that when I get close to that crease, it's really easy for me to be precise. And then I went in with Violetta again with a small blending brush and just kind of made the crease a little bit more defined and blended it out more. Then I patted on some Too Faced glitter glue, which by my mistake I grabbed the wrong bottle. I actually ended up using my It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye, so definitely use glitter glue, so this didn't turn out exactly the way I wanted it. But then I took the copper face and body glitter from NYX and patted that all over my lid. And then I went in with a really small angled brush and put more Violetta on the crease because I want the crease to be defined and that glitter kind of gets everywhere. then I went in and just kind of blended it out. Next, I'm going in with the NYX Matte Black Liquid Liner. I highly recommend doing this before you put the loose glitter on. I wasn't really paying attention and just kind of doing my thing, and I put the wing liner on. So you're going to see me kind of not struggle with it, but take some time to build up the depth of the color. So it's way easier to work with once you put the liner on, let it dry, and then you pat on the loose glitter. So you can see I was really struggling with those little loose glitter pieces. Then I'm just putting Violetta with a small blending brush on my lower lash line and blending that out. And then I went in with an even smaller definer brush after this towards the outer corner of my eye, and I took the Kai Shadow Bronze palette and I took the dark brown that's in there. I can't think of the name off the top of my head, but I'll put it in the description box, and I just kind of placed it on the outer corner of my eye to the where my pupil hits. Next, I just went in with some Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. You guys know this is my all-time favorite. I'm just putting a light layer on my lashes, the upper and lower. And then off camera, I'm going to be putting on my favorite Luxe lashes from Eyelure in Baroque. So that is the finished look, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give this video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any about me questions, put them down in the comments below. And I will see you guys next time.